It's a career that began literally in grade school. Beyonce Knowles was raised in an upscale Houston neighborhood by her father, Matthew, a sales executive who would become her manager, and by her mother, Tina, Beyonce's creative muse, who owned one of the most popular hair salons in Houston. It became one of her daughter's first venues.
Shake it, Beyonce, to left to right.
You've been doing this since you were 9 years old.
That's when I started performing at Walmarts and you know, wherever we could perform. We didn't become professional until we got a record deal around 12 years old.
So who wanted to do this, you or your parents?
Absolutely me. Once I saw Jackson 5 and Michael Jackson, I'm like, oh my God. The second I got on the stage, I just opened up and I became this whole other person on the stage, and I wanted to do it every day, all day.
With her best friend Kelly Rowland and two other pals from Houston, they began winning talent contests. And by the time they were 16, the quartet had morphed into Destiny's Child, one of the most successful pop groups of the 90s. Homeschooled, underaged, and traveling with her parents on the road, Beyoncé skipped the boys and the after parties and passed the time on the tour bus with the other girls reading the Bible.
We were nice ladies. I mean, I'm not saying that we were perfect teenagers, but we were raised well. And honestly, we were too busy to trying to be superstars. We didn't even have time to think about it, honestly.
You have a really sort of clean-cut, wholesome reputation, and then out there on the stage, you're a seductress.
Okay, thanks. I'll take that.
You're seducing the audience.
Really, I don't think about it too much. I'm just free. And I can express my sensuality. I can express my pain, vulnerability, my strength. All of those things.
Where did you learn all that stuff?
Well, just because I had a sheltered upbringing doesn't mean I haven't been a woman. I'm a woman that has had life experiences.